Ramadan, Ramadan, welcome holy month Ramadan, welcome Ramadan.
نستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Indeed, we begin with the praise that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala His assistance, and we beg for our forgiveness. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the evil of our own selves and from the evil of our sins. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends to the straight path, guides to the straight path, none can misguide him from that path. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes to lead astray, then none can guide him to the straight path. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a slave and final messenger. فَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. O you who believe, fear Allah the way He is supposed to be feared, and do not die unless you are in a state of Islam. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. O mankind, fear your Lord who created you from a single person, and from him, his wife, and from them both, he created many men and many women. And fear Allah again, to whom you demand your mutual rights. And do not break off your relations with your close relatives, for verily Allah is ever watchful over you. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. O you who believe, fear Allah the way He is supposed to be feared, and always speak the truth. He will direct you to do good deeds and will forgive your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has indeed, and inshallah will indeed, achieve success in this life and the hereafter without any doubt. Amma ba'd, as for what follows, inna aslaka al-hadithi kitab Allah wa ahsan al-hadi wa hadi Muhammad al-Nabiyan sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Indeed, the most accurate and the best of all speeches and the truthful speech is the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best of all guidance is the guidance of our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, the worst of all matters are those that are innovated by people. And every innovation is a dhalalah, is a misguidance. And every misguidance leads its people to one place, and that is Jahannam, an-nar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I firstly ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on this blessed day of this blessed month, to send His peace, mercy and blessings upon us and upon our family members, and help us to understand this khutbah, and increase our iman and taqwa through it, and more, and inshallah more, accept our good, whatever little they are, in this beautiful month of Ramadan. Ameen. Allahumma ameen. I start this khutbah with the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the glorious Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah number 2, and ayah number 38 and 39. The context of this verse is, it starts from ayah number 30, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to the angels, and He says that He's going to create man, and He creates Adam alayhi salam, and then He teaches him knowledge, and then asks everybody to prostrate, and then shaitan doesn't prostrate, and then Allah orders him not to eat from a plant, from a tree. And then shaitan slips in and makes Adam alayhi salam to eat from that tree. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ نَحْبِتُوا مِنْحَا جَمِيعًا. Get down from Jannah, all of you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as a mercy for Allah, for Adam alayhi salam, asked his repentance before getting down from Jannah. He says, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. And whenever my guidance comes to you from me, whenever my guidance comes to you from me, and whoever takes my guidance, فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. He will never have fear, nor he will grieve in his life. SubhanAllah. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, all of us are either born Muslims or some of us have accepted Islam. Alhamdulillah, that is one of the greatest blessings that Allah has given us. But by Allah, there is a greater blessing than just being a Muslim. There is a greater blessing than just being a Muslim, and that is being a guided Muslim. All of us can live a life of Islam. But the key to success is being guided. Because by Allah, it is only those who are guided and walk on the straight path of our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show him mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show his mercy on the day of judgment and admit them into Jannah. As Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3 and Ayah number 132. Whoever obeys Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever obeys Allah and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will show him his mercy. Subhanallah. When we talk about blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the greatest blessings is guidance. By Allah, it is only through this guidance that we are able to walk on the straight path. If you ask, what is blessing? What is a blessing? A blessing is something that increases you in goodness. A blessing is something that brings about justice in our society. A blessing is something that brings about harmony and peace in our society. A blessing is something that brings about a purification and happiness from within your soul. A blessing is something that, end of the night when you sleep, by Allah, you get sleep. That is the greatest blessing, brothers and sisters. Imagine after a full hard work's day, you go to bed and you can't sleep. You have so much of depression and stress that you're not able to sleep. When you sleep, that is a blessing, brothers and sisters. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the glorious Quran mentions so many blessings on this Quran, that the Quran is full of blessings. And today, inshallah, the Jummah Khutbah is a blessing for mankind, and that is the Quran itself. It would not do justice to Ramadan if Ramadan comes and goes and we don't speak about the Quran at all. I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I would not do justice to Ramadan. And hence, I've chosen the topic, a blessing to mankind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran in Surah Al-A'raf, Surah number 7 and Ayah number 158. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the Nas. Who is Nas? The mankind. The mankind is An-Nas. Every single human being, whether he is a Muslim, whether he is not a Muslim, whether he believes in Allah or doesn't believe in Allah, he comes under the word An-Nas, mankind. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the mankind, إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. I am a Rasul. I am to the mankind a Rasul, a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of you. Every prophet of Allah, every single prophet of Allah who was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a message was only sent to his nation, to his people, to his nation. But Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came not just for the Arabs, but came for the mankind, came for the entire mankind. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. When a Rasul was sent, when Allah's messenger was sent to mankind, surely he had a message for it. Surely he had a message for them. And Allah talks about the message in Surah Yunus, Surah number 10 and Ayah number 57. Allah says, Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind, there has come to you a message, an advice from your Lord. Subhanallah. Allah is subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning there has come to you a message from your Lord. And Allah says this message is three things in this ayat. The first, it is. Brothers, I request you to give place to the sisters and please move this side. Jazakallahu khair. Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa barik wa sallam wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. May peace and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on our beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I was mentioning to you a surah, an ayah of the Quran in surah Yunus, surah number 10 and ayah number 57. There has come to you an advice from your Lord. And this advice is three things. The first Allah mentions, it is a healing for that which is in your hearts, for that which is in you, a disease. What is this disease? It's hypocrisy, it's doubt, it's disbelief, it's depression. A Muslim can never be depressed in his life, brothers. When he knows the purpose of his life, the purpose of creation, how can he be depressed in life? Subhanallah, it only shows his weakness in Iman when he is depressed in life. When he has no goal, when he has no direction to move. Allah says that it is a healing for you. Second, Allah says it is a guidance for the mankind. Third, Allah says it is a rahmah, it is a mercy from your Lord. Subhanallah. And how did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start the verse? Ya ayyuhan nas. He didn't start Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu. He never started with O you who believe. He says, O mankind, if there has come to you, it is from your Lord. Every single person. And this is what we say. The Quran is a blessing for mankind and not just Muslims. It is very unfortunate that we Muslims believe or think that the Quran belongs to us. By Allah, no. It belongs to every single person who has come in this nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether he believes or not, that's secondary. But the Quran belongs to him. It is for him. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Ibrahim, Surah number 14 and ayah number 1. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kitabun, this is a book. This is a book. And he starts with Alif Lam Mim Kitabun. This is a book that it was sent down upon you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that you, O Muhammad, so that you may bring mankind from darkness into light, from gloom to noon, from darkness into light. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's job, role, was not just for the Muslims. It was his duty to bring the entire mankind. It was his duty to bring the entire mankind from darkness into light. And we are his followers, brothers and sisters. How can we stop ourselves from doing da'wah? How can we stop ourselves from inviting non-Muslims to Islam? How can we stop ourselves from not opening the Quran and pondering over and calling people saying, this is an advice for you and for me? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Isra, Surah number 17 and ayah number 82, Allah says that we have sent down this book. We have sent down this book which is a mercy and a guidance for those who believe. It is a mercy and a guidance for those who believe. Why? Because we take it and we follow it. But those who reject the Quran, Allah says, it increases the ghalimun nothing but in loss. It only increases them in loss. If you and I reject the Quran, what is the difference? What is the difference between you, between me and the person in this ayat that Allah says that he will only be increased in loss? When you and I reject the Quran, brothers, Allah says the Quran is a mercy and a healing for those who take it. And those who reject it, it is a loss and it increases them in loss. And in our second khutbah, we will know one ayat, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Those who turn away from the Quran, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise them on the Day of Judgment. Allahu Akbar, Nasrullahi Afiya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect me and protect all of you from that state. Ameen, Allahumma Ameen. Today, it's so unfortunate, brothers and sisters, that we as a Muslim nation, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started the Quran with Iqra, with read. We have gone back to the nations of the past. We have gone back to the nations of the past. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran how the previous nations acted upon their kitab. Acted upon their kitab in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah number 5, and Ayah number 15 and 16. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal kitab, O people of the book. And Allah gives them an opening, an insight as to what they used to do with their books. Subhanallah. And see how it's not different than what we are doing with our kitab, brothers and sisters. Allah says, Ya ayyuhal kitab, O people of the book, there has come to you a messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, showing you and explaining to you your scripture which you used to hide and pass over. Allahu Akbar. Today, brothers and sisters in Islam, how many Muslims are hiding the Quran, not coming towards it? It is only the month of Ramadan we begin to open the Quran and just read through Arabic without any understanding. How many Muslims, 11 months untouched, we literally hide it, wrap it up in our green or red cloths and hide it, and we pass over it, we look at it, and subhanAllah, the most amazing thing, the same Quran lies above our television sets for 11 months. We flip channels, we change channels, but we never open the Quran. Allah says, the people of the Kitab, the Jews and the Christians used to hide their Kitab and pass over the scriptures. And Allah says, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are the one to explain those things that they used to hide. And Allah says, indeed, Allah has sent down two things, a light, that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and a book. A book through which, whoever, Allah doesn't say Muslims, whoever seeks to please Allah, Allah will remove him from darkness into light. Subhanallah. Again, Allah is warning the previous nations. Allah is warning the Jews and the Christians. And in this ayah, Allah is warning the Muslims, do not follow what the past nations have done. Open the Quran, brothers, for in it is a blessing. Surely in it is a blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you ponder over the Quran, when you read the Quran, when you're able to understand the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you yourself will say, by Allah, this is a substantial proof. This is a sufficient proof for me to say, La ilaha illallah. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3 and Ayah number 18, by Allah, the scholars of Islam have said, this ayat in the entire Quran is a gift from Allah to the people of knowledge. How is this ayat a gift from Allah to the people of knowledge? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse testifies. I don't testify. You don't testify, brothers and sisters. Allah testifies. He says, Shahid Allahu la ilaha illallah. Allah testifies that there is no God but Allah. And then Allah says, even the angels testify, wal malaika. And then Allah says, wa ulul ilm. And even I bear witness on behalf of the students of knowledge, that the students of knowledge bear witness that there is no God but Allah. Subhanallah. This ayah is a gift from Allah to the people of knowledge. And when you study the Quran, you only say the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4 and Ayah number 174 and 175. Allah says, certainly there has come to you a substantial proof. Certainly there has come to you a sufficient proof in the Quran. In the Quran. So whoever believes in Allah, how do you believe after the proof has come? So look at this verse below, Allahu Akbar. Look at the verse, brothers and sisters. Allah says, certainly there has come to you a sufficient proof from Allah. So whoever believes in Allah, meaning you first understand the proof. You take the proof in your life and then you say, I believe in Allah because of the proof. He says, whoever believes in Allah and holds fast to Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring him, will guide him to the straight path, and may admit him into gardens, admit him into Jannah through His mercy and grace. Subhanallah. It is only because you understood the proof that you believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah says, when you hold fast to Him, Allah will guide you to the straight path. And then out of His mercy and grace, He will admit you into Jannah. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the month of Ramadan where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the glorious Quran. And do you know, brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the best for the best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the best for the best. You might ask me how? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Ramadan, the best of all months. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Makkah, the best of all cities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the best of nights, Laylatul Qadr, for the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the best Rasul for the Quran, Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the best angel, Jibreel alayhi salam, to get down the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the best language. There is not a single language that can even match Arabic in all languages. Arabic. Six things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose. For whom, brothers? For you and for me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3 and ayah number 110. وَتَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. If you invite people to the Quran and ask people to stop sins, Allah says, then you become the best nation. Subhanallah. If you abide by the Quran and ask people to stop sins, then you and I become the best nation which Allah has raised due to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's kitab. Subhanallah. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, I end this first khutbah with a beautiful verse for you to ponder over. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra, Surah number 17 and ayah number 9, that He says, this is the Quran that guides you to what is just and what is right. SubhanAllah, today we need it, brothers. We need justice on this land. We need what is right on this land. There is so much of oppression. There is so much of torture. There is so much of, so many things that are going on in front of our eyes that are not just, that are unjust. Allah says this Quran is a solution to mankind. This Quran is a solution to all our problems. Why? Because it leads people to what is just and what is right. And whoever works towards righteousness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will admit him into Jannah. Subhanallah. So there are two things, brothers. The Quran brings justice in our life, brings what is right in our life, and the Quran. And when you work hard towards it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the doors of Jannah and inshallah will admit us in Jannah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم ولسائر المسلمين فأستغفره إنه غفور رحيم. I say this and I ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for my own self first, and then all of you sitting here and all of the Muslims all over the globe, inshallah. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and mercy in all parts of the globe in this month of Ramadan. And I recommend you, brothers and sisters, seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for indeed He is the one who forgives and He is the one who is most merciful. Bismillah walhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. We begin with the praises that belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace, mercy and blessings upon the Imam Anbiya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his companions, upon his family members, and upon all those people who follow him in accordance until the day of judgment. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, in this second khutbah, I remind myself first, and then I remind you, that this book, even though is a blessing to mankind, in particular, is a book that we Muslims need to adhere to, hold fast to, so that we may fear Allah, so that we may increase our iman, so that we may become closer to Allah, so that we may follow the path of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that we may have mercy of Allah. Don't forget, brothers and sisters in Islam, if you have started the Quran in this month, forget the past. Subhanallah, you have taken the best step of your life. And if you haven't started, by Allah, it is not too late, because you are still living. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated a hadith. In fact, there were two men who came to Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One They came to Allah's Messenger and said, Ya Allah, I want to die in the cause of Allah. I want to die in the cause of Allah. And he fought and he struggled and he died in the cause of Allah. And the second man, he was just an ordinary man. Used to pray 5 times a day, probably read the Quran once in a day. And he died a year later. He died a year later. And then Talha radiallahu anhu saw a dream. Saw a dream that he was standing near the gate of Jannah. And the angel of Jannah was telling, Ya Talha, go back, it's not your time. Ya Talha, go back, it's not your time. And he saw those two men. And the second man who died after a year, who was just an ordinary man, was called to Jannah first. And the shaheed who died in the cause of Allah was asked to enter Jannah second. Talha was shocked. He ran to Rasulullah. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I saw this in my dream. Is this true? Allah's Messenger said, Na'am, it is true. He says, Ya Rasulullah, why? And how did the second man get Jannah first? He says, because he got one extra Ramadan. Subhanallah. Even though a shaheed died, brothers, even though a shaheed died, the shaheed is the greatest martaba you can ever get in your life. But that man got one extra Ramadan. Don't misuse this Ramadan, brothers and sisters. Allah has given you life in this Ramadan, make use of it. Allah has sent down the Quran in Ramadan, make use of it. Don't just stand in Tarawehs and let the Tarawehs pass by. At least take one surah. Be it the smallest of surah, but try to understand it in this Ramadan. Make it a habit, 5 minutes, 10 minutes of your life. Do not stop this habit after Fajr, after Dhuhr, or any time. Once a day, brothers and sisters, do not let go of the Quran. For verily, listen to this, the verse that I'm going to narrate from now. Inshallah, of Surah Anfal, Surah number 8 and Ayah number 2. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Whenever the verses of Allah are recited, only the believers, Allah says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, only the believers, fear Allah and raise their iman, and increase their iman. Subhanallah, how many tarawehs have passed by, brothers? Why hasn't our iman increased? How many tarawehs have passed by? Why hasn't our iman increased? Because we don't fear the verses of Allah. Because we don't understand the verses of Allah. Allah says, only those who are believers, only those who can understand my verses, zadatul iman, their iman will increase. Subhanallah. And this is the month, brothers. This is the month that if you have not opened the Quran, this is the month for you to open the Quran. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hadid, Surah number 57, ayah number 16. Hasn't time now come? Hasn't the time now approached for you to be affected by the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the time that you and I have to be affected by the Quran, brothers. This is the month. This is the month that if you don't open the Quran, then when will you open it, brothers? 10 minutes, 15 minutes, one ayah or two ayahs a day. Don't let go of it. And Allah warns you, whoever turns away from my reminder, whoever turns away from my Quran, in Surah Taha, Surah number 20 and ayah number 124. This is the ayah I said. Look at the warning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives. Whoever turns away from my Quran, he will have hardships in his life. Allahu Akbar. Your financial problems, your debts, the rent that you can't pay for your life, for your home, the food that you can't eat 3 times a day, the job that you can't secure, the job that you've never got, you're still looking for a job after 2 years. The problems that you have in your marriage, the problems that you have within your children don't listen to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is because you turned away from my reminder. Allahu Akbar. Whoever turns away from my reminder, two things will happen. There will be hardship in this life, and then on the day of judgment, he will be raised blind. Allahu Akbar. Why? Because he never read the Quran. Allah gave him eyes to read, and he never read it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Taha, Surah number 20, ayah number 124, that he will be raised blind on the day of judgment. Allahu Akbar. Brothers and sisters, do you want to be raised blind on the day of judgment? The greatest ni'mah on the day of judgment is looking at the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine you and I are blind, brothers. We can't even see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The man who is going to be the shafa'at for you and for me on the day of judgment. How then can we let go of the Quran, brothers? How can we let go of the Quran? I end my khutbah with a verse of the Quran. for you to ponder over, and I'll leave you with a question, inshaAllah. The verse of the Quran is from Surah Al-Furqan, Surah number 25 and Ayah number 30. Who is Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? A man who came to bring us, a man who came to guide us, a man who came with mercy, a man who was sent to as a mercy for us, brothers and sisters. This same man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on the Day of Judgment, this verse of Surah Al-Furqan, Surah 25 and Ayah 30, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger will say, Ya Allah, these people deserted the Quran. Throw them in Jahannam. Allah. Ya Allah, it is the mercy, it is the most merciful man that ever lived. He will cry out to Allah, say, Ya Allah, these people deserted the Quran. Throw them in Jahannam. Allah. I leave you the question, brothers and sisters in Islam. The question is, do you want Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to bear witness for you or against you? The choice is yours. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabarak asmuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha khayruka. Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa barik wa sallam wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Allahumma atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azab al-nar. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Oh Allah, this is the month of Ramadan. The doors of mercy are open. The doors of Jannah are open. Your mercy is open, Ya Allah. Help us to open the Quran. Help us to open the Quran, Ya Allah. Help us to understand the Quran, Ya Allah. Oh Allah, make the Quran the joy, the noor of our hearts. Oh Allah, through the Quran, let sorrow, let depression, let every problem depart from my life, from our lives, oh, Ya Allah. Oh Allah, make the Quran and a way that you will admit us into Jannah. Oh Allah, make the Quran something that brings joy and happiness in our life. Oh Allah, solve all our problems through the Quran. Oh Allah, help us to take the Quran in this life and never, never leave it. For verily, it is something that will intercede for us. Make it intercede for us, Ya Allah, on the Day of Judgment. We need an intercession, Ya Allah. We need an intercessor. Make the Quran, make Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam intercessor for us. Oh Allah, we ask you to protect the women of this Ummah. Oh Allah, we ask you to protect the daughters of this Ummah. Oh Allah, we ask you to protect the youth of this Ummah and every single male and female of this Ummah. Oh Allah, guide us to the Quran. Help us understand this Quran. Oh Allah, make this Ramadan a Ramadan that is the best of our life. Oh Allah, protect the Muslim nation that are being oppressed. Oh Allah, open the doors of your mercy. Oh Allah, we ask you for goodness in this life and the hereafter. اتل ما أوحي إليك من الكتاب وأقيم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر وأقيم الصلاة